Welcome to part one of converting fractions to decimals. In this video, we'll take a look at converting fractions to decimals by converting the denominator to a power of 10. There are really two main ways to convert a fraction to a decimal without a calculator. Number one, covered in this video, is to convert the denominator to a power of 10 and then write the number using the correct place value. And the second method, covered in part two, is to perform long division. With either method, it's important to know place value. So if we have the decimal point here in the middle, to the right we would have the tenths, hundredths, thousandths, and ten thousandths. And to the left of the decimal point we'd have the ones, tens, hundreds, and so on. So the idea is, if we have fractions where the denominator is a power of 10, we should be able to write this in decimal form if we know our place values. First, we should be able to recognize our denominator is a power of 10, because if we wanted to, we could rewrite this as 2 over 10 to the second power. So if we know this fraction is 2 hundredths, looking at our place value chart, we know we have to have two decimal places to the right of the decimal. So if we write the numerator down, and we have to have two places to the right of the decimal, it would be 0.02. Again, we have the tenths here and the hundredths here, 2 hundredths. Another nice way to double check is, notice that our denominator would be 10 to the power of 2, and this power of 2, again, tells us how many decimal places we must have to the right of the decimal. We have a power of 2 and two places to the right of the decimal point. On this next example, we have 15 over 1,000, which is the same as 15 over 10 to the third. Again, our denominator is the power of 10. So if we have 15 thousandths, notice the thousandths place value has three digits to the right of the decimal point. So we'd have to have 0.015. Again, we have the tenths, hundredths, thousandths, 15 thousandths. And again, notice our denominator was 10 to the power of 3, and we have three decimal places to the right of the decimal. Now let's take a look at what happens when the denominator is not given as a power of 10. Here we have 7 25ths, or 7 over 25. We need to ask ourselves, what can we multiply 25 by to convert our denominator to a power of 10? Well, 25 times 4 would give us 100, which is a power of 10. And we can do this as long as we do the same to the numerator. So the equivalent fraction would be 28 over 100, or 28 hundredths. Again, if we know our place value, we know this would have to be 0.28, because we have the tenths and then the hundredths, two digits to the right of the decimal. Our next fraction is 6/5. To convert our denominator to a power of 10, here we can just multiply by 2. 5 times 2 is equal to 10. So we'll multiply the denominator and the numerator by 2. This is going to give us 12 over 10. So we have 12 tenths, which means you must have one digit to the right of the decimal point. So if we write down 12, we have to place the decimal between the 1 and the 2 so that we have the tenths place value. So 6/5 is equal to 1.2. Let's go ahead and take a look at a couple more. Here we have 303 over 250. So we do have to be able to recognize that if we multiply this by 4, we would have 1,000, which is a power of 10. So we'll do the same to the numerator. This will give us 1,212 in the numerator. And our denominator is going to be 1,000. So if we have the thousandths place value, we're going to have three digits to the right of the decimal point. So we'll go ahead and write down our numerator, 1,212. And to have three digits to the right of the decimal point, we'll have to have the decimal point right here. So this fraction is equal to 1.212. And let's go ahead and look at one more. 9 over 2,000, or 9 2,000ths. If we multiply our denominator by 5, we'd have 10,000, which is a power of 10. So we'll do the same to the numerator. So here we have 45. 10 thousandths. And again, the 10 thousandths place value would have to have 4 digits to the right of the decimal point. So we'll write down our numerator. If we need to have 4 digits to the right of the decimal point, we're going to have to add a couple zeros here. So 9 over 2,000 is equivalent to 0.0045, or 45 ten-thousandths. So converting the denominator to a power of 10 is a nice way to convert a fraction to a decimal if the denominator can be easily multiplied by a factor to obtain a denominator that's a power of 10. If we're not able to do this easily, we'll have to perform long division, which will be covered in part 2. Thank you for watching.